Packed into my sugar bag, I had a few items of clothing besides my typewriter and a few books. With much literature always in my head, I thought I resembled a good number of young men who had taken to the road in search of some kind of fortune. A newcomer to our town joined our Bible class. In his presence, I was astonished to experience physical excitement. I've written to Frank, but I can't bring myself to send him the pathetic expressions of my bewildered, tortured soul. How is it that love comes to some men and not to others? I read day and night, gulping down everything, especially Tolstoy's use of the clear statement repeated, until all is added up into something powerful. To glance at the library index was to feel once again the intolerable weight of civilization. I wondered why on earth I should want to concern myself with the past at all. Surely the sensible thing was to cut oneself free. Except to buy food, or to take a walk on the beach, I remained in the batch, wrapping myself in the evenings against the winter cold and reading into the morning hours by candlelight. The rotted walls let in the cold, almost as if there was no protection whatsoever. After years of trial and error, I had moved in the direction of composing short, clear sentences which, in a vivid and unexpected way, would transmit a great deal of what readers might fairly grant to be common human experience.
My uncle wears a hard knocker. His wife put him up to it.